There's like so many of Cal's guys just keep coming back time and time again. What is it about that, talk to you about Big Blue Nation, that keeps you coming back to do these things?
The same thing from when I, you know, was a 18-year-old, 17-year-old kid and I committed here. You know, I committed to a family. And, you know, me and Coach still have a great relationship to this day. He came out and told me to play this year. Whenever I can come back, you know, I love to.
Julius, there's a lot of talk around here recently about Lonzo Ball versus De'Aaron Fox. How do you weigh in now as a guy who's got to stay in the fight?
I mean, obviously, De'Aaron's a great player. I love him through the whole, you know, season and the whole draft process. But my point guard is, you know, Lonzo. I'm excited to play with him. Excited, you know, to build chemistry with him throughout the season. Obviously, De'Aaron's going to have a great career. You know, he's going to be an excellent player. So, you know, that, I guess that rivalry is going to live forever.
How close were you and D'Angelo Russell, and did it kind of like, did it like hurt you as his teammate to see him go, or was it just kind of more like y'all worked together? Like,
yeah, it was tough. It was tough. Obviously, I mean, you're with somebody every day, you know, 6-7 months out of the year, and then throughout the summer. Most of the summer, you're with somebody, so you build a relationship with people. Obviously, it's tough, but, you know, everybody sees it as the nature of the business. So. Can't really take any hard feelings out of it. You just gotta move on and you know, just continue to get better. And, you know, obviously we'll see each other down the road. Still out in Los Angeles living, so still talk, but you know, it's just the business.
You've had about two outstanding years since your injury. Are you fully recovered? What was that like having to sit out that first year?
It was extremely tough. Yeah, I'm fully recovered. I feel better than I have in like probably the last 4 or 5 years. So I feel really well. It's obviously extremely tough. You know, when the game that you love, something you love to do, is taken away from you. But it was also a tremendous growth process for me, you know, as an individual, as a person, and, you know, as a basketball player. So in a way, the year was needed at the same time.
Bill, you've been sitting here all season from afar. What's it like being in the middle of it, people moving around, all kinds of different teams?
It's crazy, but I mean, what can you really do? Like, you know, it's, a lot of stuff is out of your control. So I really try not to pay too much attention to it. But, you know, I just focus on what I can control, and getting better, and enjoying my off season, enjoying my, you know, my fiance, enjoying my son. So, you know, that's what I focus on.
What are your first impressions of seeing Lonzo play, and especially what he did in the summer league?
He makes everybody better. You know, he's a great player. He obviously can score, but he makes the game a lot easier for everybody. He makes the game very simple, and I think the way he plays is contagious.
What's your favorite thing about the camp that you're doing today? Like, what to teach the kids? Like, what do you want to impart on them the most?
Just being around the kids. You know, I always say, like, you know, growing up as a kid, I didn't really have the experience of dealing with guys you look up to or pro athletes. So I take it very serious being able to, you know, talk to these kids and put a smile on their face or block their shot, whatever it may be. You know, just having fun and interacting with this community, honestly, you know, the parents as well, you know, giving so much to me, you know, my year that I was here. This place is like a second home for sure.
Has your perspective changed since you're a parent yourself now?
Say it again.
Has your perspective of kind of these camps changed at all since you're a parent now yourself?
I've always taken it, you know, serious when it comes to kids. Just like I said, because of my experience growing up. You know, as a parent, now being a parent is kind of crazy, but. As a parent, you know, you kind of cherish that relationship that I have with my son. You know, I really cherish it, and every day getting to see his face and to spend time with him and making sure, you know, dad is there. So I know other parents have the same feeling, so I really do, you know, enjoy these moments and giving back to kids for sure.
LA is a lot different than Dallas or especially Lexington. How has the adjustment been to life on the freeways?
I try to stay off of them. I live close to the practice facility. I try to avoid the traffic, honestly, because it's miserable. I'm not going to lie. It's miserable. Here you go 4 miles, it'll take 5 minutes. Here you go 4 miles, it might take you 25 minutes. So I try to avoid it, and I try to stay home as much as possible. So the town I live in is really convenient. I got everything I need. The beach is right there. Food's right there. Facility's right there. Kind of like the lodge set up. So I try not to leave my area.
In your couple of years, you guys have undergone a lot of changes. Kobe's farewell tour, the Magic comes in. What has this been like for you?
It's a great experience. Being around Kobe, my favorite player growing up, having that relationship with him, to all the changes that we've gone through as a young team, now Magic here, being able to pick the brand of these greats, it's been good. So, I wouldn't change it for anything in the world. And, every day is, I take every day one day at a time, and I just try to leave it at that. Can't really, like I say, control the other stuff. You can only control what you can control, that's your effort, getting better, all that type of stuff.
You mentioned playing on a young team. You played on a young team here as well. Are there any similarities? I know college ball is very different.
It's a lot of similarities, honestly. And I think it's kind of why I've been able to, stay a little even keel, because I kind of have a perspective, coming from a young team. Here at Kentucky, struggling early and then, kind of finding our niche and making a run. So it's been an experience that's allowed me to, keep perspective, with our team now. And, we're growing every year. Everybody's getting better, so it's just only a matter of time.
Who's been talking around here lately that maybe for the alumni game, it would be Kentucky players taking on a super team out there? Just curious about your thoughts on that. Kentucky players taking on the Golden State Warriors or another team?
My friend mentioned that to me yesterday. I had no clue about that. They just told me about the alumni game. And I was thinking about coming, but yeah, I had no clue about that, but I definitely think we would win. I don't think it'll really be a challenge. I think Kentucky just has too many stars that come out of here, too many really good players. So, I'm never going to sign with lose.
What starting lineup do you think would stand a chance? Like, what would you go 1 through 5?
I have to let Coach choose that. Me and him might have.
You don't have any type of input with that?
Before I agree to this game.
You're starting them, right?
I've always put myself in.
I saw one of your tweets, I think it was to Dakari, congratulating him about his contract. Do you still keep in touch with some of the guys that you play with here?
Absolutely. I was on FaceTime with Dakari yesterday. So we were talking about some of the times that we had here. And he's coming to my wedding in like 2 weeks. So I definitely keep in contact. AP, I see Willie all the time. You see everybody, and it's just like old times, the twins. I saw James probably a week ago. So, every day is just like old times when you see each other. It's a little bit harder, but I definitely keep in contact.
Speaking of those young guys, have you had a chance to give them some advice now that they're in the big league?
You talking about my teammates?
Like Fox and Monk and those guys in this one?
I haven't had a chance, but anybody that went to me for advice or anything, I don't hold back. So. Just kind of figure out your way, honestly. You get thrown into the fire, and day by day you learn something new, but you figure out your way, and those guys will too. Coach does a really good job of preparing for that, so it really wasn't a big adjustment for me coming here to the NBA.
Yeah, I remember Booker said travel was the hardest thing.
Yeah, travel is really hard. I think for me, just taking care of your body, learning how to take care of your body and get your body ready, you know, from day to day, practice to practice, so you can get maximum, you know, effort.
I'm assuming you've heard the LeBron LA rumors and everything that's been going on there. Have you ever played with LeBron? And just, I know that, you know, LeBron's a great player and whatnot, but like, how would that change for you as, you know, as being like, I guess, the power forward on the team and LeBron coming? How would that change for you, and have you ever played with him before?
Well, I mean, other than, you know, those camps you go to in high school, no. But, I mean, so much speculation in the NBA these days. How can I really, you know, speak on it? If it happens, it happens. If it doesn't, it doesn't. But, I mean, who's to know? Who knows? Only probably him and his family know what he's going to do. He probably doesn't even know what he's going to do. So I can't necessarily speak on that because I don't really know what's going to happen with that.
There's a picture of you on the internet going around this summer. You kind of transformed your body over a pretty short period. Are we going to see a different version of you on the court this year?
Yeah, I think. You know, when I talk to Magic, you know, our GM, Plink at the end of the season, you know, the biggest thing was for me, you know, I keep working on my skill, my shooting, all that type of stuff, but getting in the best shape possible. You know, he had mentioned to me during, you know, the pre-draft workouts to do all those testings and all that type of stuff. And I think the fastest end-to-end speed that they had since my draft class or before was one that I did. You know, I think I had the fastest time. So it just shows, like, my physical abilities to be able to run the floor, you know, get the rebound, push it, whatever it is. So the biggest thing is me getting the best shape possible so I can do that, you know, throughout the course of a whole game, you know, every possession. So that's really all it's about. And, you know, if I don't get tired, I feel like I'm at my best. I mean, anybody's like us, so just got to get the best shape.
Have you gotten a chance to get a good look at the players coming into the UK team this year?
I have not. I saw when I came here a couple weeks ago, I saw, you know, some of them in there in the gym working, you know, knocking those guys. But I have not seen too much of them. But, I mean, every year we have the number one recruiting class. So, what more can you, you know, you ask for? Now, I definitely, during the season, I'll give me time to watch our game. So I get a lot more familiar with the players, and I'll see them out here today and talk to them. So.
What's your relationship with Coach Walton, and how is that different than your relationship with Coach Cal?
Two different approaches. You know, I have an amazing relationship with Coach, and I have an amazing relationship with Coach Walton. But I mean, it's just two different approaches. They're two different guys. Coach is a lot more, you know, gritty. Get up under you, and they both. Coach Walton's more, you know, calm, kind of like his dad, chill, relaxed. But they both know how to connect with me and challenge me in different ways. So, you know, my relationship with Coach Walton is great. You know, I talk to him, you know, all the time, and you know, it's an amazing relationship.
Couple more questions, guys. What kind of wedding gift do you expect from Coach Cal? So what kind of wedding gift do you expect from Coach Cal?
That'd be something good, man. All the screaming he did at me, the running, the yelling, he took him to a national championship. It gotta be something good, a car or something.
Who's the teammate you gotta be most worried about misbehaving at that wedding?
Ex-teammate, probably Nick Young. He has no filter, no sense.
What do you miss the most about Lexington, your time in Lexington?
Just the community. The growing up, you can literally feel yourself, you know, maturing more, becoming a better basketball player. It's tough, but the way you guys embrace us, you know, the fans, everybody embraces us. It makes it all, you know, worth it. And then it goes so fast. And then in the end, you're like, man, like, what happened? Like, where did my time go? And, you know, you got to grow up. You got to go to the next stage. But, know, I just miss, you know, the community, the relationships that I established, being able to communicate with, you know, certain people on an everyday basis. You know, KB, those guys, Coach Cal, my teammates. So it was tough leaving for sure.
You watched the 30 for 30 on Cal?
I did.
What did you think?
He's the same as he was, young as he is now. But it was great. You know, they did a great job as far as, you know, going throughout his career. You know, really just seeing how he impacts lives and changes lives. You know, obviously I have a more, you know, personal connection with it because how he impacted me and changed my life. But, you know, he turns, you know, kids, guys come here as boys and, you know, they leave men and they have a different perspective on life and cherish things and, you know, have more accountability and all that type of stuff. So, I mean, it's amazing to see how he's able to do that at a young age and, you know, still doing it to his day.
Did you see Keller's drive-by dunk challenge video?
I did. I did. He was hobbling trying to get over there to the goal. But it was good. Yeah, it was good.
All right, thanks, everybody.